Hey everyone, welcome to Photoshop Pro Help. Now today I'm going to be teaching you how to make this awesome flaming text effect. Now this effect is really easy and simple to create and it only takes a few steps. So first things first, it's going to need a new blank document. So go up to File, go up to New, and you can really have any size document that you want. It's really to suit and fit what you're actually doing at the time. So click OK once you have put in your sizes. I've put 1920 by 1080. Click OK. You want to make sure that you have a black document, so a black background. So you want to make sure, go to your foreground color, make sure it's default black, and then go to your paint bucket tool and click your document to set it as black. Now once you have done that, we're going to go to our text tool on the left hand side. And you can have the text any size that you want, it's really up to you. I've gone for 180 in size, and click. And you want to make sure that the color of the text is going to be set to white. And you can really have any font that you want. I've gone for Myriad Pro, that's the font I'm going to be using. So we're just going to type out our text right now, so you can really have anything that you want. So I'm just going to type in hello. And the next step, what we're going to do is we're just going to duplicate this because we're going to be needing this again. So it saves us from having to re-go over a few steps. So Control and J on your keyboard duplicates the text. So what we're going to do with that duplication is we're going to just hide that now. So we're just going to go to the icon now on the right hand side and just hide that top one. So we're going to be working on the bottom text layer at the moment. So click the bottom text layer and we're just going to go up to Filter, we're going to go up to Blur and go to Gaussian Blur. It's going to be asking you to rasterize it, so we're just going to go click OK. And you want the radius of 4 pixels, click OK. And the next thing you're going to do, go to the left hand side and go to the Smudge tool. Now if you can't find the Smudge tool, it might be hiding underneath the Blur or the Sharpen tool, so just click and hold and then click Smudge. Now you want the strength of 50% and the size of your brush really is to suit the size of your text. So I'm just going to make this brush a bit smaller and then all we're going to do is just smudge, just making some flames from the text like that. So I'm just doing this very quickly just to show you. So just keep working. You might want to just go back a few steps if you have done it wrong. But it's pretty standard from here. Not much to do. Like that. The next thing we're going to do is add an adjustment layer. So bottom right hand side, you see a little circle that's black and white, click that and go to color balance, and we want to go to the drop down menu on tones and go to shadows. Now the cyans and reds are going to be set to 70 and you want to go to the yellows and blues and that's going to be -70. And we're just going to go to the drop down menu, make sure the magenta and the green is set to 0, go to midtones next, go to cyans and reds, that's going to be set to 70 again, magentas and greens is going to be set to 0, and yellows and blues is going to be -70 again, and we're just going to go to the highlights, cyans and reds are going to be set to 70, magentas and greens is going to be set to 0, and the yellows and blues are going to be -20. So click that and then just hide that. Now once we have done that, we're just going to go and unhide the top text layer which we hid earlier. So click in the eye. Now it's white at the moment, we need that text to be black, so we're just going to double click our text icon and that's going to highlight our text. Go to the top at the top of the panel and change the color from white to black. And we're just going to go and change the blending mode to, we're just going to go and change that to overlay. And we're just going to double click that text layer. And we're just going to go to the pattern overlay. And you want to go to the drop down menu. And you want to go and make sure that you have the default patterns available to you, and you just want to go and click that clouds pattern there. You might want to go and load a few of your patterns that you have just to search for it, but it is there. So make sure you got the clouds clicked on, and I'm just going to go to the blending mode and make sure that is set to a vivid light, and then click OK. Now once you have done this, I'm just going to go and make this a bit bigger. So I'm just going to go hold down Control and select all three of them, Control and T, and hold Shift and then drag out, and click the tick icon, and there we have it. That's the basic steps of making some flaming text. So with a bit more time, obviously you're going to make a better document like this one here. As I said, a lot more time on your hands than me. So go ahead, play around with this text, show me what results that you do get. If you need any help, just comment, rate and subscribe, and I'll see if I can help you as best as I can. So that's it for this tutorial today, and I'll see you next time, guys. Bye for now.